see something down there. Language this.
Again, it's there and then it's not. What does it mean?
There's something down there.
Thank you.
something down there. This waterfall is even bigger now that the water's dropped.
Let's get to it. Anything you need, young sir. And we're back to you. What a surprise. You don't have to run off on my account.
Thank you.
This is it, right? The Rockstall?
Aye, lad. The Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the Great Hall of the Einherjar, is their home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Why?
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues? Placing one of the Valkyrie helms on a throne. Gunnar, Mistress of War. After any conflict, big or small, she would be first on the scene, sussing out the worthy spirits for a free trip to Valhalla. A gruesome task, but she took great pride in it.
Any conflict? Impossible.
It's true. She had help from her sisters, of course, but Gunnar was always first to arrive. Her judgment of the fallen was unparalleled, and an invaluable resource to Odin. She was one of his favorites. This, my friends, is Kara. Now, Valkyries are volatile by nature, but Kara, the lass is wild storm personified.
A wild storm?
Aye, calm and collected. Then the air would shift and the fury of her storm would unleash. It was beautiful in a way, assuming you could find proper shelter. Her tears would cleanse the blood-soaked battlefields.
Death itself I swallow, to spring forth life tomorrow.
Oh, I like that one. I wonder if I wrote it.
Is that the answer there?
Says Earth.
Swallows death, brings forth life.
Go.
Yeah. I wish I'd known I was a god in Alphine. I wouldn't have felt so bad about killing so many elves.
Well, I'm not sure that's the lesson.
You've done nothing to regret. The elves forced their affairs upon us.
No, I get it now. We had god things to do, and they were in the way, dragging us into their little problems.
Again, are we just leaving that there?
Just knowing we're gods makes us so much stronger.
Maybe you feel a little too good right now. With power comes a big choice, lad. You can either serve yourself, or put your godhood in the service of others, like Tyr did.
People really loved him, huh?
Aye. The god of war, but one who fought for peace. Had a reputation for being heroic and lawful, using his power and knowledge to stop wars rather than start them.
So there are good gods?
Once in a moon, it's been known to happen, yes?
This one mentions places I've never heard of. Seems Tyr really liked to travel.
Tyr believed the mind, not might, was key to preventing war and chaos. And he also knew visiting other cultures would give him perspective staying in one place could not. While Odin always hoarded knowledge, guarding it jealously, Tyr was open and sharing with his learning and his wisdom. For this, mortals adored Tyr, showing their love by bringing him gifts the world over.
So, whatever happened to Tyr?
Odin came to regard him as a threat to his rule. He suspected Tyr of collaborating to aid the giants instead of helping to steal their secrets for the Aesir. Same thing he accused me of, frankly. Though in Tyr's case, I believe he was right.
You think Tyr was helping the giants?
I do. He felt responsible for the suffering visited upon them by Odin. I suspect he had something to do with helping them cover their tracks.
The missing Jotunheim Tower.
Correct. Whatever happened to it, I believe it could only have been done with Tyr and the giants working together.
Where is this black root?
Don't know. I've never been in here.
The stone! That has to be it.
That easy.
No. It's gonna go through. So what now?
Brother, up there! The winds of hell.
The winds of what?
Oh, we forgot to mention that. When you were sick, we went to Helheim to get your cure.
You did?
Terrible experience, by the by. Your dad picked up a new trick, though, with a little help from Brock.
Brock was there, too? We'll get back to this.
Ah, a skiing dew from my homeland. I used to have one of my own back in the day. You should take it, boy.
Yes, boy. Take it. You might need to butter bread somewhere like that.
This is why no one likes you.
Well, that's unfriendly.
Look, small passages on either side. Perfect for the boy.
Too small for father, though.
Go. I will be fine.
Careful, brother. Rhea's not here to bring you back if you're cutting two.
Quiet.
What'd you find?
Enough distraction. Do not forget why we are here.
Okay.
That's from a great desert land, very far from here.
Do gods live there?
Oh my, yes. Many, many gods.
Good or bad?
Not as simple as that, I'm afraid.
Focus up, boy!
Important to you.
It was a rash impulse. You need not dwell on my failings.
Wow. That was almost too funny.
Stands to reason the second ring should behave like the first. Just need to capture the winds.
Atreus, to me.
If it hurts me or not, I want to learn. Just because you hate being a god doesn't mean I have to.
More small passages.
No. Go.
I can't watch brother. Good luck.
And I thought those saws were scary.
That's right. The bringers of day and night.
Ragnarok begins when they catch the sun and moon. Right? Did Tyr know them?
I don't know. Like them well enough to cover a massive wall in his vault with them, though.
Don't you enjoy it at all? And adventure in some amazing place. Maybe Mother wanted us to have a little fun. Everything we've seen and done. Maybe it was her gift. I don't see another trap for the
Winds of Hell? Maybe we can get up to one of those balconies for a better look.
You know, for someone so loved, Tyr sure was paranoid.
Aye. Thanks to Odin, with good reason.
What of these?
Thought is faster than wind.
Perhaps this isn't about speed at all. Is there someplace else the winds can go?
Ugh!
forever.